Batman 3 Jokers book number 2 was published a few days ago and continued with the story of the three Jokers, the comedian, the clown, and the criminal. Written by Jeff Jones and penciled by Jason Fabok, we last saw how Jason Todd killed the clown after he reminded him how he killed him in the past. Book number 2 opens with the comedian imagining that he is having dinner with his wife and son. The criminal, however, enters the room to find that the comedian is having his dinner alone, sitting with a mannequin and a torn teddy bear. The criminal tried to awaken the comedian from his dreams by saying that one of them is dead. Meanwhile, Batman and Commissioner Gordon investigate another victim by the Joker, and this time it was the corrupted Judge Walls, who was killed by his own dogs, which were turned insane after they were exposed to the Joker's toxin. Batgirl then arrived and informed Batman that Jason killed one of the Jokers. She was mad at Jason who committed a crime, but Batman tried to calm her down, saying that the Joker hurt Jason, but he healed wrong and got more violent. They then went to Blackgate Prison, and on the way, Batman told Batgirl that he examined the body of Judge Walls before the police arrived and found out that he was bludgeoned to death by his humanitarian award before his dogs got to him. The fingerprints on the award belonged to no one but Joe Chill, the murderer who shot Batman's parents. Batman went into the prison and headed towards Chill's cell. He said that he wanted to talk to him, but nobody was in there. Batgirl then said that they moved him to the hospital wing because he is sick and dying. He has cancer stage 4 and has been there for over 2 months. She then asked how Chill's fingerprints were on the award, although he is dying in the hospital. Batman said that someone slipped in and paid a visit to Chill to get his fingerprints and replicated them. He then said that Jason accessed the bat computers from his helmet and that he found the other two Jokers. Meanwhile, Jason arrived at Gotham City Athletic Association, where he went into the swimming pool, which was full of victims who were exposed to the Joker's toxin. He remarked that it was safe to breathe before taking his helmet off. Suddenly, one of the victims attacked him, but he knocked him away, only to be captured by the Jokers from behind. They beat him until he lost his consciousness. Jason then woke up to find himself naked and tied to a chair. He told the criminal that he killed the clown and that he is going to kill him as soon as he gets free. The comedian, however, put the helmet on Jason's head after he painted the Joker's smile on it. He then started beating Jason with a crowbar, saying that it is more fun than it was the first time. Meanwhile, Batman and Batgirl broke into the place and started looking for Jason, only to be attacked by the pool's victims who were exposed to the toxin. The mindless victim stripped Batman of his belt and accidentally activated the button which called the Batmobile, which broke into the place and took down the victims. Batman and Batgirl then found Jason tied and beaten up. The frightened Jason woke up and told them not to touch him. He said that the Jokers want to make another Joker who knows Batman well and hates him. Someone like Jason, who took it on Batman, accusing him of putting him on this path. Batgirl then calmed him down and said that she just wanted to take him to a safe place. Jason then woke up to find himself at Barbara's apartment, sleeping in her bed. He found the wheelchair which she used after she was shot by the Joker. He also found a book about how to deal with chronic pains. Barbara then came back and checked on Jason, who apologized for looking through her things. Jason remarked that what the Joker said about how he has been on the path to being like them for years wasn't wrong, but he doesn't want to be like them. Barbara said that she lived a tragedy that she was able to walk away from, thanks to the people who loved her. Jason, however, said that he never had people who loved him, but Barbara said that they always loved him, but thought that he was dead, including Batman himself. Jason said that no one has ever said that to him, but Barbara said that she is saying it now, before kissing him on the lips. She then said that they should have never done that, but she just wanted him to know that she cares about him. Later on, the Jokers broke into the Blackgate prison and kidnapped Joe Chill. They gave him back his hat, then turned on the camera and started recording. The book ends with the Joker asking Chill why he killed Thomas and Martha Wayne. Although I haven't found anything special about the plot so far, I still enjoy Jason Fabok's incredible artwork. Let me know what you think about this run so far, and don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Thanks for watching, and have a nice one.